his wings! Doesn't matter if you like me or not! I'm here for you!
Have time?
No, we don't. It'll kill them. And then it'll kill you. Let's heal the world, Pete. Together.
Give me some room. I don't know if it's gonna work, but I gotta try.
Pulse is weak. We gotta move.
What have you done?
What have you done to him?
I'm so sorry.
I'm coming with you. Wait.
There are traces of brain activity, but his chances of coming back are very slim.
Just keep him alive.
Get the G-Serum ready, ASAP.
For the last few years, tragedy has tried to tear the city apart. But we somehow kept going. We battled sickness, evil, cataclysm. We are tired, anxious, stressed, numb. But we have never lost hope. The city needs to heal. We're all ready to return to normal, but what is normal? What if it no longer exists? Over the last half hour, I've talked about how these events have changed me. But what about you? In this ongoing series, I will be talking with people throughout the city, exploring our new behaviors, new routines, new thoughts and feelings. I hope you'll join me on this journey. This has been Mary Jane Watson, and you're listening to The New Normal. Episode one, done.
Nice.
I don't know.
Are these good to go?
In a minute, I want to show you something first.
Okay.
It has molasses in it.
Yum, I'll take those.
Thanks again for the donation, Peter.
Have you talked to Miles about?
Not yet.
You ready?
Miles. I've been meaning to talk to you about something. I mean, I have been talking to you all the time. It's great to talk. So many good talks. I just haven't been talking to you about what I should have been talking to you about.
Pete.
Let me start again.
I got this. All of it. Go be Peter Parker for a while.
Are you sure? It's a big city.
I can handle it. As long as I can still call you for advice.
You don't need it.
Maybe not now, but there'll come a time.
I'm here for you. Always.
Big bro. See you.
Yes.
What do you want?
The Spider-Men. You know who they are, don't you?
Why?
They ruined my son.
Good. We all have to experience loss. Even you, Norman.
What are you writing?
The final chapter.
Hi. I hope you're hungry. Food's almost ready. Why don't you go show her your essay? He worked so hard on it.
Guy in Harlem. Probably seen him volunteering in the city, helping out his city council mom, and trying to live up to his hero dad. Yeah.
Hi. Miles, Haley, this is Albert.
Hi. Nice to meet you. Oh, and this is my daughter, Cindy.
What's up, New York?
Welcome.
Actana Club. We did it. You got a package here at the house.
Okay.
I put it in the garage for you. It's from Norman Osborn.
Oh, interesting. Thanks for letting me know. Break time's over. This? Lance and a thumb drive? They say you should never plug in a drive of unknown origin. But I know Norman, I think.
Because I knew when we got through this crazy time, whenever we got through it, I wanted you to have these. And I wasn't positive I'd be here to give them to you myself.
Harry.
After the Emily May Foundation was destroyed by Kraven's hunters, I went to see what I could recover before it got boarded up. In the box, you'll find a piece of bark from my mom's tree. And one of May's blossoms. And I thought, if you gene splice them together, you might get a hardy enough plant to produce seeds. We salvaged from the field studies. We just leveraged their relocation data sets to plant those seeds around the city.
You're some kind of genius, Harry Osborn. Let's get those bees working.
I know. It'll be years before we see the results. And who's to say where you and I will be a week from now, let alone years from now? Which is why I did this simulation to show you. So Emily and May will live on in the city, and of course, in us. I love you, Pete. I really do. And I know the Foundation didn't end up going the way I'd hoped, but there's still no one I'd rather have tried it with. I bet by the time you get this, we'll have already started a new Foundation. Just me and you. From scratch. Go us.
Go us.
One last thing. I got a little something for you. Wear good health. Love you. Good health. Love him.